To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Michael Bengson of AIA Philippines. Good afternoon, Michael. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Stanley, and good afternoon to your viewers.
It's good to have you here. Now, it's another winning day and a good start for the week with trades mostly positive, of course, in contrast with our neighbor's performance today. What propped the sentiment today in the market?
Yeah, well, there was good news in China, as you mentioned. There were statements made which were supportive of China's property sector, for one. Mm-hmm. And we saw the Hang Seng index up so far this trading day, as you mentioned. But I would still point to the positive momentum generated from the CPI print in the U.S. last week, mm-hmm. the October CPI print. If you recall, core CPI in the U.S. was up 0.3% month on month. For October, and that was below the consensus estimate. So that actually prompted a very strong market response in the U.S., right? So if you recall, Thursday, Friday, U.S. equity markets quite strong on the hope of a possible Fed pivot. And the expectation for the Fed terminal rate noticeably declined below 5% for next year, right? So mm-hmm. this is what generated the positive sentiment. Notice also that the peso appreciated since then, back to the 57 peso level.
Okay.
That was in response as well to the CPI print. So this strong peso, as you would imagine, is good for equity markets. In general, a weak dollar is positive for emerging markets, the Philippines being no exception.
Okay, so you're saying it's partly a spillover from last week, but we're still finishing strong, 63.54. Some analysts saying we are nearing a breakout zone. Really? I mean, what indicators are you waiting for to make that observation convincing?
Yeah. It's, going back to the CPI print, one must bear in mind that the, this is just one data point. Mm. And the market will be closely watching the next releases of macro data going forward. So to confirm that inflation really is indeed firmly on a downtrend and the Fed has been able to create some slack in the labor market, between now and the next FOMC meeting on December 14, which is 15 in our time, there's still quite a bit of macro data to come out, right? Specifically, I would say the jobs report on December 2nd, as well as the November CPI print, which will come out December 13th. Mm-hmm. So I think the market will wait for confirmation. But so far, the momentum from the October data print is already sort of propelling the market further.
All right. Of course, in the horizon, we still see some clouds, the BSP policy announcement upon us. And this time, it's not just about rate hikes itself, but the figure which the BSP had hinted. Now, it is in step with the Fed. That's about 75 bips. Today's prices seem to have ignored what's looming. Have we become immune to rate hikes? And has the market accepted these policy changes as a regular occurrence in the near term?
Yeah, I think the BSP has told the market well in advance the intention to raise its rate by 75 basis points. So it's quite expected already, right? So the communication has been there. Also, I think more importantly, the BSP has said that effectively, they would maintain 100 basis points spread over the Fed policy rate, right? So that slight tilt towards, further hawkishness on the BSP, I would say, is contributing to some extent to the recovery of the peso as well. Mm-hmm. And I think, that's been well received by the market since, as if you recall, the first half of the year, the weak peso has been blamed really for the weakness of the market here, right? So, this stability in the peso that we're seeing can only be a positive thing for equity markets in the Philippines.
All right. Another thing that might have been propelling the markets, of course, third quarter earnings were on the final stretch of revenue reports. And many Philippine companies, of course, are saying they're having mixed earnings vis-a-vis expectations. Which companies, or at least sectors, perhaps, are you most disappointed about in terms of third quarter earnings?
Yeah, it's tough to find a disappointing result, actually, since I think by and large, the third quarter result season was quite good. And we saw more earnings beats versus expectations compared to earnings misses, right? So much more. And concentrating on the positive, really, we saw strong third quarter generally from two sectors. The consumer sector, I would say, sort of showed, the strength in terms of profitability in that sector, as well as the banking sector also. But having said that, we also saw a few positive surprises in the property and transportation sectors, right? So almost quite consistent with the strong third quarter GDP number that came out, right? We're seeing strong profits as well from Philippine corporate. So there seemed to be some consistency there from micro and macro.
Okay, lastly, Michael, stock picks in terms of bargain prices. Of course, we know we're in the 6,300 level now, and a lot of people might think they've missed the boat. But which stocks would you recommend to your clients and why?
Yeah, without going into specific stocks, we still like, I would say, the consumer sector at this point in time. Mm-hmm. You know, the reopening of the economy has been a constant theme for the most part of this year, and we actually still see this driving revenue growth for a good number of companies in this sector, right? Clearly, still a bit more momentum to go in the second half of the year. And this is bearing in mind that, the return to face-to-face classes was something that was put into effect just a few months ago.
Right.
So we should still see the impact of that, in the fourth quarter as well as the first half of next year.
All right, Mr. Michael Bengson of AIA Philippines, thank you so much for joining us and for your market guidance. Good afternoon.
Thank you, Stanley.